Hello and welcome to Mangatora 96, and today we continue with the Straw Hat crew discussion. Today's focus will be on everyone's favorite skeleton musician of the Straw Hat Pirates, Brook. This video will be in the same style like my other Straw Hat discussion videos were. I will go over Brook's personality, his role in the story, and his combat abilities. Before we start, here's a brief overview on who Brook is. Soul King Brook is the musician of the Straw Hat Pirates and one of the two swordsmen. He is the 9th member of the crew and the 8th to join, doing so at the end of the Thrill Bark arc. Brook ate a Yomi Yomi no Mi, which allowed him to return to life after dying once. Brook eventually learned to tap deeper into the power of his devil fruit, giving him nominal control over his own soul and the souls of others. His dream is to reunite with his old friend Laboon at Reverse Mountain, where he resides with Crocus. Originally a member of the Rumber Pirates, he died and was resurrected through the power of the Yomi Yomi no Mi. However, due to the amount of time it took for his soul to find his body, it was reduced to a skeleton, keeping only his afro intact. Brook drifted alone in the Florian Triangle for 50 years, eventually meeting Luffy and serving as the Straw Hat's ally during the Thrill Bark arc before officially joining the crew. He currently has a bounty of 83 million berry. Brook is an eccentric character with a distinct personality of his own, like the other Straw Hat Pirates. While he looks like and thinks himself to be a gentleman, he does possess vulgar and perverted manners, such as asking to see women's panties, although in a mermaid's case, he asks if they can lend him some money. However, he asks the former question to the mermaid princess anyway, yelling impatiently for food, a trait shared by Luffy, and occasionally burping and farting conspicuously. Despite his behavior, he still remains very polite, formal, and soft-spoken in speech, usually referring to people using the respectful son, and always speaking to everyone, even enemies, in a very courteous manner. He appreciates the simplest of things, from a gesture of kindness to company of others and walking in the sunlight after receiving his shadow back. Brook was moved to tears at just being able to share a dinner with people after decades alone in the Florian Triangle. Despite his eccentric behavior, Brook is an extremely upright and compassionate person, befitting of a true gentleman, as Brook utterly disdains wickedness and cruelty. When Zeo began to ruthlessly assault his own men, Brook even defended one of the enemies from Zeo's attack, reprimanding Zeo for his cruelty. Brook's compassion is shown in Zo, where he was horrified by the immense devastation the Beast Pirates caused. He readily helped the badly injured Minx along with his crewmates. After Luffy arrived at Zo, Brook gave specific instruction not to mention anything about Wano and Samurais out of consideration for the Minx. He even beat up Luffy for mentioning Raizo out loud, although it turned out to be for nothing. After Yasue was executed, Brook was solemn and sympathetic when Hiyori explained how the citizens of Ebisu Town lost the ability to feel or express sadness and despair after being fed faulty smile fruits by Orochi as a part of his twisted tyranny. His reaction to different occurrences can be somewhat extreme, often comical so. For example, when the Straw Hats were alarmed at him for being a living skeleton, he forgot the object of fear was actually himself and also began to panic. Although he tends to display more extreme emotions at times, Brook has been known to overrelax when he is told to stay calm. He is also very patient, having stayed on his former cruise ships for years, waiting for the day when he would eventually be reunited with his shadow. However, due to his rudeness, he can also be impatient about things like waiting for dinner to be served. Brook's most notable trait among others, however, is that he cracks skull jokes about himself being a skeleton, complimented with his distinct laughter of yo-ho-ho-ho, even if there is no one around to hear him. When Chopper broke one of his jokes by saying what he intended to say beforehand, Brook became temporarily depressed. While stuck in the Florian Triangle, Brook discovered his skeleton body was now very limber and developed a strange gag to keep himself entertained, going completely ripped and then leaning against a wall or object at a 45 degree angle. Though he mainly used it to show it off in front of people and his crew just for a laugh, Brook later turned this into one of his signature poses as the Soul King. He has sometimes practiced and attempted to tilt even further than 45 degrees, but if he makes the angle too acute, he will lose his balance and slip. He can even run around in circles while maintaining this pose. When Nami had him be a lookout, as half the crew was headed for Zo. Brook struck his 45 degrees post and didn't check any other angle, causing Nami to yell at him to look in every direction. So Brook began a 45 degree rotation, annoying her with his antics until she attacked him. Brook is a great lover of music. In times of joy or sorrow, music is what generally keeps Brook going. When he was about to die during his first life with his fellow members of the Rumber Pirates, Brook suggests playing and singing a song with their last breath. As a result, his love for music often reflects itself in various other aspects of his character, such as in his fighting style, wherein the names of his attacks are derived from various songs and dances. He gave himself a musical theme so noticeably that while he was alive in his first life, he was called Humming Brook by the authorities. In contrast to the other cowardly crew members' own fears, Usopp being out of insecurity, Nami's as a survival instinct, and Chopper from cautions, Brook's fear is more down to earth. He fears the things that are not normal. An example would be that Brook is easily scared by the ghost and zombies, despite technically being deceased himself. In order to fight the various trail bark creatures without fear, when he encountered them, Brook convinced himself that if he sings while fighting, he would not be afraid of them, though he starts running in fear when he stops singing. This singing while fighting, however, had a side effect of making him seem like a more sinister creature to the zombies. A rather ironic fact due to him being the contrary and the fact the song he sings during battle being one of life and joy than one of ominous threat and evil as perceived by them. Because of this, despite his equal fear, he was given the name of Humming Swordsman by the zombies and was ironically feared by them in turn. He apparently does not like moving fast, evident when he was in the more intense rides at Sabaody Park. Linked to this is moving at high speeds via the Flying Fish Rider's Flying Fish or the theme park's rides and fighting a Pacifista cyborg there was little chance to win against. Comically, most of those fears are things he himself has the potential to intentionally cause, such as being an almost living skeleton that can run so fast that most people would have little chance to win against. Before encountering the Straw Hats, Brook was very lonely while floating adrift on his ship and longed for the company of other people. He initially accepted Luffy's offer to join the crew and invited himself over for dinner upon arriving on board the Thousand Sunny, just so he could interact with the crew and fill the void that he experienced all those years. Also, while possibly one of the oldest pirates alive, Brook still retains an air of childness about him that enables him to behave in a manner similar to Luffy and Chopper, noted by the ease with which he participates in their childlike antics. His distinct personality and laughter allowed Nami, Usopp and Chopper question a guardian of Hogback's lap, Ryuma, who had Brook's signature laughter and personality. This was because Ryuma possessed Brook's shadow until the samurai was defeated by Zoro, upon which Brook's shadow was returned to its rightful place. Awkwardly, Brook has a tendency to lack common sense in slightly frantic times. For example, when Luffy falls into the water, Brook and Chopper for that matter, jumps into the water despite being a Devil Fruit user himself. He also has a tendency to accidentally go on rides that go obviously fast and sit out on slower rides. He appears to take offense if someone avoids him because he does not have any substance. During the Punk Hazard arc, Brook grew furious at a dragon for rejecting him, claiming that bones have plenty of nutrition. However, during the Zoo arc, most of the canon minks from the mink tribe constantly beat Brook due to him being made of bones, which he did not enjoy at all. Brook believes in and has quoted the philosophy, "Good things come to those who wait." Given the years he spent on the ghost ship, joining the Straw Hats and learning of Laboon's patience. However, one issue he has stood by is the act of wasting lives. As he had experienced death, he knows more than most about the consequence of dying. He shares a very strong emphasis on keeping promises and friendship, as he will do everything in his power to reunite and fulfill his promise to Laboon, his long-lost friend, something Franky had complimented him upon. Though he is prone to being childish, he proves a loyal and fearless friend. An example of this is when he was standing between Usopp and the Pacifista, stating that he shall protect him even though he knew his chance of survival were slim. Even Zoro has quietly acknowledged that Brook is a true man to his heart, facing down odds that are near impossible, unflinchingly to save a friend. As possibly the ultimate example of this, he shows absolutely no fear in facing of Big Mom, an emperor, who is specifically able to use an opponent's fear against them. He even goes so far as to call her young lady during their fight, an unprecedented sign of contempt for someone of an emperor's status. Like Sanji, Brook's mind is often filled with lecherous thoughts. Ironically for his relationship with Sanji, her two women whose beauty Brook has exponentially complimented are Windsmoke Reijo, Sanji's elder sister, and Charlotte Pudding, Sanji's arranged bride. In the case of Reijo, Brook even expresses regret at not having lips with which to receive a kiss from Reijo. Brook is also chivalrously protective over women, as is Sanji, as he chases the new fishman pirates for aiming their firearms at Shirahoshi. Her, unlike Sanji, Brook is not against fighting a woman to protect his friends or to complete an important objective. He defeated Jola to cancel the effects of her devil fruit powers and battled against Big Mom to keep the copied writings of the Poneglyph safe. Though he knows other songs, Brook's favorite song to sing is Bing Sake, which he was singing upon his first appearance. Even when he asks for requests from the others, he seems to instantly switch over to singing this song. Other songs Brook sings include Black Handkerchief of Happiness and his originals, Bound to Be Wild and New World. Brook is also clever enough to trick Jola into turning his weapon back to normal by pretending to side with her. Brook's attitude of waking up the crew in person is seen when he woke up the Rubber Pirates with his song White Handkerchief, much to his old crew's annoyance. His attitude carries on to the Straw Hats when he woke them up in person, much to their annoyance once again. The Straw Hats were immediately wary of Brook prior to his initial entry into the crew, save for Luffy, who invited him on board the Thousand Sunny. But this changed after the events of Thrill Bark. Despite his obnoxious personality, Brook deeply cares for his crew, going so far to protect Usopp and Sanji from Kuma. His eccentric personality often gets on the crew's nerves, showing no appropriate respect for Nami and even Robin when he asks to see their panties, and makes skull jokes in serious situations, which often lead to him being beaten up, even shattering Robin's normally limitless patience. This is likely due to his long years of isolation with no real human contact. Nevertheless, Brook's sense of humor and music can enlighten an organization as big as the Thrill Bark Victim Association. Frankie is moved to tears upon hearing Brook's backstory, and the rest of the Straw Hats gain respect for him, even Usopp and Chopper, who were initially afraid of him, after hearing about his devotion to keeping his promise to Laboon. During Brook's fight with Charlotte Linlin, he says that the worst case scenario for the Sanji retrieval team is if Sanji deciding to not rejoin the crew, and when asked about it by Big Mom, he refused to presume that any of his friends will die during their mission. As much as Brook normally goes around on the ship, engaging in acts of silliness with Luffy, he is still a formidable opponent, due to his previous experience and skills that he amassed from the days when the Pirate King Goldie Roger was still active. Brook in all respects is a veteran pirate, though those attributes are somewhat downplayed by his overall demeanor, along with the fact that his isolation in the Florian Triangle seemed to have eroded his knowledge of modern society. When Brook fights, his battles often have a comical element to them, including making a few of the members of his own crew fall asleep while fighting the flying fish riders, playing dead halfway through a battle, or launching himself at an enemy with erroneous results. His childish personality occasionally hampers his effectiveness, though he often gets scared easily by powerful enemies or the supernatural. He can be very calm and fearless to defend his crew, such as when he willingly sacrificed himself, hoping to hold back a pacifista and Kuma, and when he cleverly realized he could trick Jola to defeat her. When he first met the Straw Hats, he quickly proved to be an asset to them during their encounters with Thrill Bark's many undead inhabitants. After the time skip, Brook's overall skills have proven to be a very important asset during battle, as he defeated the energy steroid-powered Zeo with no difficulty and cut down Jola of the Don Quixote Pirates. When fighting to reclaim the Thousand Sunny, he and Chopper battled and defeated several of Big Mom's chess soldiers. This earned them praise from Charlotte Katakuri, one of Big Mom's suite commanders. Brook has demonstrated tactical ingenuity as shown when he used his music to act like he was on Joala's side, allowing him to regain his sword from here and defeat her. He also got the idea to store the copies of Big Mom's poneglyphs inside his head before she confronted and later captured him. He's very good at working with others to execute plans in tandem, as shown when he took advantage of Pedro's distraction to get around his strongest opponents and enter the Room of Treasures. He also disguised himself as a clone of Luffy to take advantage of the chaos when Luffy crashed Big Mom's tea party and he destroyed Big Mom's portrait of Caramel without being noticed. While he was still alive, Brook ate the Yomi Yomi no Mi, a Paramecia-type devil fruit that allowed his soul to return to the world of the living and re-inhabited his body after he died. This allows him to reside within his own dead body, which had already decomposed into a skeleton by the time his soul found its way back to it. And he can even perform all the functions he did when his body contained flesh and muscle. Other than bringing him back from the dead, Brook's fruit initially seemed useless. However, he later discovered that he could exercise the power of his strength and soul, which he discovered is what allows him to animate his body. He can make his returned soul temporarily separate from his body, so that it can move independently of his body, effectively making him a ghost. This leaves his body a lifeless husk, but as a spirit, Brook is capable of moving through walls and going to areas that will be impossible for him to physically reach, though he cannot grab hold of anything. If his skeletal body is broken into pieces, he can extend soul tendrils to the severed body parts and pull them back into place. He is also capable of exerting his soul powers to affect and overwhelm beings with weaker souls, such as homies. His soul energy exudes pure coldness, called the chills of the underworld, and allows Brook to transfer this freezing aura to objects like his sword. With this aura, he is capable of freezing his surroundings, as seen when he turned the ground around him on Zo into ice. Brook uses a type of sword called a Shikomuza, a sword concealed inside a cane. He uses this sword in conjunction with his fencing skills and has had it for at least 50 years. As a former battle convoy leader and a pirate captain with years of experience in the Grand Line, Brook is a master in swordsmanship. Despite his usual goofy personality in battle, he is an extremely skilled swordsman who is able to dispatch numerous enemies at once with swift and precise strikes. His swordsmanship is a combination of classical fencing and iaido. Brook's gentle blade style is more focused on speed and precision, while Zoro's style is more focused on power and thus uses a tremendous amount of physical strength. Brook was unable to defeat Ryuma no matter how hard he fought, and while Ryuma only used a fraction of his power, he noticed that Zoro was able to defeat him at full power with only two of his swords. Although Ryuma did say that Brook's protectiveness of his afro held him back somewhat. While at Sabaody Archipelago, 2 years ago, he struck a pacifista using a high-speed sword attack, yet failed to do much damage to it and had to be rescued afterwards. However, when Zoro attacked the same pacifista, the results were very different. He was able to keep up with what Zoro was doing while he watched the swordsman fight Ryuma, showing his sharp perceptive for swordsmanship. He works very well with Zoro as they defeated a flying fish rider together. After the time skip, Brook has named his sword Soul Solid due to him developing the ability to coat it with the aura of his soul, freezing it in the process and anyone who comes into contact with it. He also claimed that the long-armed tribe has helped him sharpen the sword. His power and skill in swordsmanship has also increased to the degree where a samurai from Wano has commented his skill, and he is also now able to use flying slash attacks, which were on par with Zoro's and Kinemon's. Like Zoro, Brook can now cut materials that are harder than steel, and he was able to cut down a dragon whose skills are tougher than steel. Brook is a virtuoso musician who is extremely skilled in playing all kinds of instruments, particularly the violin, his favorite instrument. After he was separated from the Straw Hats, Brook picked up the guitar, and within 2 years he became so highly skilled in the new instrument that he came to be regarded as a world-famous rock star. As testament to this fact, his records in tone dials sold in the millions, and his fans during his final world tour stop in Sabaody Archipelago were either crying or fainting at his presence. Brook can masterfully play enhancing songs that are so melodious they can completely captivate even animals like Laboon, who used to sing along to Brook musics. In addition to singing and playing music, Brook is also a skilled composer, having composed songs such as Born to be Wild and New World, which proved to be very fashionable among music fans and lovers. There's a lot more I could talk about Brook, but this is already a long enough video as it is, so it is the perfect time to end it here. Next week I plan to cover the Doctor mascot of the Straw Hat Pirates. Look forward to it. And that will be all for this video. If you like this video, leave a like, leave your thoughts in the comments below, or subscribe to the channel for more One Piece content as well as other manga content. And until next time, take care.